Flexing on my exes and my model ex. Pretty little skinny little bitty body model ex. Some of y'all ain't never had no real bitch and it shows. I keep it 100 from my head down to my toes. Back up on my bullshit, back up on the move. Touchdown in my hometown, got nothing to lose. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Janessa. If you don't know, subscribe, get to know me. Well, y'all about to get to know me right now. This is my best friend, Angela. She gonna be asking me the question because why not, right?
Amen.
I need her for my video, real quick. I guess I'm gonna be doing this on my own then. So, I'm asking people to give me questions for this Q&A for maybe about 6 months or maybe since I started this channel. But it's time to do a Q&A. I feel like it's overdue, but not too overdue because, I mean, y'all seen some videos and now it's time to really get to know me. I mean, a little bit because y'all still not going to know me. But you watching me, you my friend now. All right, you my sis. You watching me, you my sis. Period. Or bro, you be bro too. We family now. OTF. Question one. Do you want more kids? How many? Yeah, I do. I want more kids. I really want a family, y'all. Like, I really do want a family. But my siblings are close to my age. And that's how my cousins are too. So I wanted my son to have a younger sibling, at least a year or 2 years younger than him. But he is 3. He's turning 4 soon. Hopefully, I don't know. I want 3 kids, 2 boys, 1 girl. I need me a girl. I need me a little me. I love being a boy's mom. I love being a boy's mom. I do. All right. Next question. First job. My first job, I believe it was. I think my first job was the summer job at a daycare. It was the summer, and then after the summer was over, then I got my job at McDonald's. So yeah, it was at a summer. It was at a daycare. Oh my God, I miss them kids. Some of them was bad, but they were so cute. Favorite zodiac sign. All right. So if you know me, I'm really like into astrology, and I feel like this year I've been learning more about it and getting more into it. I love Scorpios. I love female Scorpios. Okay, I love female Scorpios. Y'all men, toxic. I do love Scorpios, and that's because I'm a Scorpio, which was another question. But Scorpios also get on my nerves. I feel like I only know 2 male Scorpios, and the 2 male Scorpios I do know. No, I know 3 male Scorpios. Two of them I do know. The other one is my best friend's boyfriend, so it's like he's still seeing. But he chilling. I always get interrupted when I'm making a video, but when I'm laying in the bed, nobody calls me. When I'm hungry and sad and tired, all cuddled up in the blanket with my pillows, nobody calls me. But when I want to make a video and be productive and try to make myself successful, y'all feel it. Next question. Ever been in a toxic relationship? Yes. Both my past relationships were toxic. Yeah. If you want to know a little bit of the toxic, I have a story time on my last breakup, my last relationship, why we broke up. So if you want to hear a little bit of the tea, go ahead. Age, how old am I? I am 20. I just turned 20, November 19. Your girl's dub club. Dub club. I'm really a dub. It's crazy. I don't know. Different. Definitely different. How was your high school experience? The school I went to, I was not supposed to be in, first off. I just transferred back because I was just living in Florida for my 8th grade year. So when I came back last minute. My dad didn't send my records or something, my transcripts or something, I think. So I went to was my neighborhood high school, so I had to go there. I had no choice to go there. I was mad at first, I'm not gonna lie, just because I knew it was gonna be all these ratchet kids. Like, I wanted to go to a music school because I wanted to do music or acting or something. Really wanted to, you know, but everything happens for a reason. Freshmen especially, you love drama. Come on now, you love drama. So you like seeing what's exciting. You want to be in the mix. I wasn't in the mix, but I didn't have to be in the mix. I knew the right people, like the right people knew me. I was really to myself, but the right people knew me, and I would skip sometimes. I'll just walk out of class at the end, like sometimes, or just walk out of class whenever I want. A lot of people just did it. And you'll walk out of class and people playing freaking Manhunt in high school. They're playing Manhunt in the halls, all right? People just running, kicking doors. It was always fights freshman year. There was a couple kids who got caught having sex in the hallway, in the theater, in the auditorium. If you know about the E, you know about K-Stairway. Them little kids doing them nasty things in K-Stairway. But my high school experience was good. But me being in high school, like, it wasn't much activities we had. We did have a couple things. And our counselor did love me and Angelares, so, and our friends and stuff, like our little group. So call me Vanessa, because I finessed my way out of high school. Senior year, I should have failed. I really should have failed. Like, me and my best friend were barely in school. We'll come to school, second period, 10, like 9 o'clock. We'll come to school at like 8:30, 9 o'clock, second period, third period about to start. Fourth period is lunch. Fifth period, we might go to that class, or we might skip, go to sixth period, might go to seventh, or just leave. We used to just go to the mall and just be out, yo. I felt like I was glowing. If you see me in my 12th grade year, I was glowing. I need to get that glow back. I was so happy. I really was so happy. But yes, I loved my senior year. Even though I couldn't go to prom, I couldn't go to none of the senior stuff. One thing about high school though, choose your friends carefully. And I know you hear this a lot, but honestly, you really should. I know sometimes it's like you want to be cool with the people that's coolest, the popular or whatever. And it was like, I was popular in my school, but everybody knew me, but I wasn't with everybody either. Like, I was with my best friend. You see me walking around, you see my best friend next to me. Like, I sat at lunch tables with, of course, my classmates and stuff. I had other friends. But it was like, you pick and choose. A lot of kids in high school want to be friends with everybody. That's not how you move. That's going to make you fail in everything, every aspect. Like, you're going to follow their steps. Now you're everything. Just don't do that. Don't try to be everyone's friend. It's not, you don't need to be everyone's friend. What's the first thing you notice on someone? What's the first feature, I'm guessing? What's the first thing you notice on someone? Okay, so first, I mean, I feel like always the face. Like, if your face not there, I'm most likely not gonna bother even looking at anything else. But now that we got these masks on, you know, I mean, it ain't like I'll be out here searching. I'll say the face, and then I have to see your lips. Face, which includes the lips, I guess. And then how you dress. And if you look clean. When did you want to start YouTube? I wanted to start YouTube maybe freshman year. I made a YouTube eighth grade year with my sisters. I don't know where that thing is. Nobody trying to find it, because I don't even remember what it's called, so most likely y'all won't even know how to find it. I tried doing a YouTube eighth grade year, I guess middle school. What apps do you use to edit videos? So I'ma just put a screenshot right here. What I use my phone to edit my videos. Favorite song? I want to do actually, I might do it after this. After this video, I'm gonna give y'all my playlist. Because mama, you gonna be like, oh shit, my house on fire. She too hot. Ah! I'm too late, y'all. I don't know what it is. What it is. Who you gonna hang with now? And that nigga dangerous now. He's gonna end up taking me out. That's one of my songs right now, actually. Alright, I'm gonna say my favorite song right now is Trust Issues from King Von and Youngin Ace. I'm like, ring, 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 answer that phone. Bitch, what's going on? Favorite artist? Favorite artist? I love music, so I just can't pick one. So I'm gonna give y'all three. Janae. Lil Durk. Hard. Third one kind of hard. All right, I'm gonna give y'all four. Brent Faiyaz. Faiyaz. I don't know how to say his last name. And Lil Baby. Wait. Oh, and Polo G too. All right. Sorry, that's five. I'm sorry. I'm undecisive. It's like, you know, it's different moves. They all have different vibes. Where your boyfriend? You really want to know where my boyfriend at? Y'all really want to know where my boyfriend at? I'm smooth, dude. Would you ever one day be into spiritual rituals? And I mean the good ones. That's how she wrote it. I mean the good ones. So it kind of creeped me out, but I mean, like, I just kind of shrugged it off. I was like, Illuminati ? But you know, spiritual, I'm good. I'm with it. I'm with the spiritual rituals. I don't know, that kind of sounds like witch. But I want to burn sage. I want to start actually meditating, get rid of all negative energy, because I feel like I've been tied down. There's a lot going on. There's so much more I want to learn about all of this. I want to get my tarot readings, psychic readings, everything. What's it like being a young mom? Honestly, being a teen mom is hard. It's different because everyone is, that's not what the teens are looking at. You see, we're all still growing. So when a teen pops up with a belly, everyone's just losing their virginity. Nobody's thinking about babies, but it happens in every generation, so it's normal. I feel like I was really embarrassed. I am gonna do a story time, but I was really embarrassed at first because I already know how people look at teen mom. I'm not gonna deny it. I used to even, in high school, it wasn't bad, but it was like, damn, that is kind of drawling. But that was young-minded. I was young-minded at the end of the day thinking that. Bro, it's December. How do y'all still have freaking fireworks? And this nigga dangerous now. He might end up taking me out. So back to what I was saying. I feel like the three main things that are like the hardest to deal with being a teen mom is school, career, and family friends. Because now, family friends, you might lose people. People are gonna criticize. People might tell you get an abortion. If you want to get an abortion, some people might tell you not to get an abortion. A lot of them will feel like it's their decision. It's your decision. With the baby, with the whole pregnancy, with all of it, the whole motherhood, it's your decision. That's your child, that's your body. Second, career. Now you have to, you know, you got your school and stuff, you wanna do work or whatever. I wanted to do singing, see, that's the thing. People told me, oh, you pregnant? Yeah, your life, you know, throw that away. The usual, you know, everybody always wanna think you can't do it. That's why you have to show them that you can. So, career-wise, it's kinda hard because sometimes you don't have somebody to watch your child. Sometimes you don't have the money to put into your career or whatever because that money is going to your child. And yeah, so on. A lot of your time is going to your child instead of being available for your career. And three, which was school. Hopefully, I know me, it was a little hard. I think like the first year my son was, I had to have a babysitter, thank God. His grandma from his dad's side helps a lot, so she used to stay with him. But so I had someone to stay with my son, thank God. But not everyone has that. And sometimes you're tired of taking care of your child. You're still growing, so you have your teenage life going on with all your emotions and mindsets changing. And then you got your family and your homework and everything. It's like, it's a lot of energy. But you can do it. It's not hard. If you are pregnant, anybody's pregnant here, if you're watching, it's not hard. It's nothing bad about being a teen mom. So many people talk shit. And I'm so glad I ain't never catch nobody saying anything out their mouth about me, besides family, you know, talking crap. But besides outside of the family, oh. Pew pew. Favorite makeup brands. All right, so I love, for eyebrows, I love Anastasia. For highlight, Physicians Formula. I love, oh my God, foundation. I love Fit Me. Maybelline, is it Maybelline? I believe. The Fit Me foundation, the dewy, which I have on right now. And hold on, y'all, because I think y'all need a quick close up. And I definitely have stuff under my eyes. Wow. I love Morphe. But I love ColourPop as well. All right. Advice on fashion. So I'm still learning about fashion. I'm still creating my own style. I'm still learning what exactly my style is. I mean, I really know what my style is. I'm starting to really, really know what my style is, but I can't really afford my style right now. So we're gonna make this work because it still look cute. So I'm chill. This chill. This is cute though. Oh, y'all ain't. I need to be more specific on this question. I don't know what exactly to like tell you. Jewelry always makes your outfits look better. Nice sneakers, you always have to have nice sneakers. Getting a jean jacket is good to add for the winter because you can always throw any hoodie under it. Black and white sweatpants are always a need in your closet. Adidas pants are definitely a need in your closet. I could say scarves and like headband, purses adds more to the outfit. And definitely your hairstyle. Sometimes your hairstyle and the lashes, if you don't put lashes, can add to your outfit. You know what I mean? Because when you have fashion, it's not just the outfit. I feel like you have to have everything go all together. The jewelry needs to match it. The hair needs to match it. The makeup needs to match it in order for the look to be a look. So get everything on fleek, girl. All right. Ain't that hard? You know, simple cute fits. Might do a video on that. We gonna see. I'm gonna give y'all some basic fits. Go-to fits. Go-to outfits for the fall. For the winter. Go-to outfits for the winter. Let me know if y'all want that. What are fashion trends you dislike? Okay, so I don't really like... Okay, I'm gonna insert a picture here. Because I don't really know what to, I don't want to take too long describing it. But I've seen someone with a shirt and I liked it at first. But then I seen people putting it with shorts and stuff and I start feeling like it's too much. I mean, some people rocked it real good. But some people wasn't like, I don't know, I didn't really like the trend too much. I don't know, I don't really focus too much on what I dislike. All right, biggest fear. I don't even want to say that loud. I think I have paranoia or something. Something's really wrong with me because, like, I'm so paranoid of this. Like, this runs through my mind almost daily. I'm so scared to wake up one day or, like, I'm taking a shower and get out the shower and everyone's gone. Like, just gone. Yeah, I think I watch too much sci-fi. But, that's one of my fears. That's honestly, I know it sounds, like, weird, but that's one of my biggest fears. Also, and of course, anything happening to my son, I don't even want to imagine. But I feel like those two. Yeah. Where you see yourself in 5 years? So, honestly, 5 years, I'm going to be 25. At 25, I want to have a business that's at least a year in, or at least starting. And I want it to be something different. I want it to be something where boys and girls can go to. You feel me? So I want it to be unisex. I don't want it just to be for females or anything. I definitely want to have a second child. I definitely want to have at least a fiance. I do want to be engaged by 25. I at least want to have one or two houses. Yeah, I at least want to have one or two houses. If YouTube is still around, I feel like YouTube definitely might be around in 5 years. Hopefully I got 6 million subscribers. No, let's make it 7 million subscribers. No, I can't put a limit to it. I could get 7 million subscribers tomorrow. Man, I don't know. Shit, I just want to be successful. I want to be happy. I want to be successful and happy. What's your type of man? Ooh, I like my man tall. I like my man brown skin with big lips. Nice smile. Big eyes. No, I really do. But honestly, I'm not too much on looks. If you know me, you're seeing my exes. But anyways, not all of them been ugly. But honestly, I don't need no little boy. Like, I want a man. I want a man that's healed. Like, he doesn't have to be fully healed, but at least healed to the point where I don't have to heal him. Because I feel like every relationship I have gotten into, and even some friendships, it feels like I'm the one that's always trying to help them and save them. And it's like, you know, the relationship is draining. So I'm always fucked at the end. So it's like, I want someone who's ready, like, grown, you know, went through their whole stage at least. Not on no toxic shit. Like, I'm really not on that toxic shit. I'm a little clingy, I ain't gonna lie. That might be the only thing that's a little... I don't know too much what I'm looking in a man, because I ain't looking. But next question. That was too complicated to even think about, because honestly, I haven't seen no good man. No man that I've been like, I just answered this. It says light skins or dark skins. Okay, I said brown skins in the little clip before. So my skin complexion, usually I don't go after. I mean, I don't go after anybody. Nigga, they come after me. They come after me. But I'm more into, I like some color. That's all I'm gonna say. I'm not too much on looks. I'm more on personality. I don't want no ignorant ass man. I don't want no little boy that likes the drama of girls fighting over him. So next question. How many siblings do you have? Alright, let me break it down. Oh, hopefully I can find a picture. I'll put it whatever side with... Okay, so I'll put my mom's side and my dad's side of the family. Which one is the hoe? Comment down below. So my mom has 3 kids. My sister, she's 24. My brother is 22. Then it's me, 20. I'm the youngest from my mom's side. Then my dad has the oldest. She's 21. Then it's me, 20. Then it's my little sister. She turns 20. I think it's December 16th. Ain't that some shit? My dad had 2 babies in the oven at the same motherfucking time. That's how I know niggas ain't shit. Anyways. Yeah, so the third one, she turns 20 this month. The fourth one, he's 18, 13. The sixth one is 12, or did she just turn 11? So that's it for today. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked the video. I hope I answered all the questions correctly. Yeah, I really appreciate everyone that watches all the way through. Follow me on Instagram at 215.nessa. You already know what to do. Comment down below what you would like to see on this channel. And thank you for watching.